Simon & Schuster Audio presents Tarantula by Bob Dylan, read by Will Patton, with a preface read by Dennis Boutsikaris.
Here lies Tarantula, preface to the original edition. In the fall of 1966, we were to publish Bob Dylan's first book. Other publishers were envious. "You'll sell a lot of copies of that," they said, not really knowing what that was, except that it was by Bob Dylan. A magic name, then. Besides, look how many copies of John Lennon's book were sold. This would be twice as big, maybe more. Didn't matter what was in it. Bob would visit our offices occasionally. It was hard for him to travel in broad daylight in those times, even to our old 12th Street and 5th Avenue building. A marvelous structure with a marble staircase and thick walls covered with portraits and photographs of people like W.B. Yeats. We had published his first book, too. All his books, in fact. One day when Bob appeared, the receptionist at the big oak desk decided she didn't care for the look of him and phoned upstairs to see if it was all right to allow him to enter. It seemed funny then because there were very few places in which he found himself unwelcome. He would go in and people would look and whisper and stand back. They thought it was poor form to press him. They didn't quite know what to say to him anyway. We talked about his book, his hopes for it, and what he wanted it to look like, and what he wanted to call it. We knew only it was a work in progress, a first book by a young songwriter, a quickly famous shy boy who sometimes wrote poetry and who was having an odd effect on a lot of us. We weren't quite sure what to make of the book, except money. We didn't know what Bob was up to. We only knew that good publishers give authors a chance to catch up with themselves. Robert Lowell talks about freelancing out along the razor's edge, and we thought Bob was doing some of that. We worked out a design for the book that we liked. Bob liked it too, and we set it up. We also made up some buttons and shopping bags with a picture of Bob and the word tarantula. We wanted to call everyone's attention to the fact that the book was being published. We wanted to help Life and Look and the New York Times and Time and Newsweek and all the rest who were talking about Bob. We brought a set of galleys to him so he could take one last good look at it before we printed it and bound it and started to fill all the orders that had come in. It was June. Bob took a break from some film editing he was doing. We talked a little about the book and about Remo and Rembo, and Bob promised to finish making a few changes in 2 weeks. A few days after that, Bob stopped working. A motorcycle accident had forced him into a layoff. The book might have been published just the way it had been left, but we could not do that. Bob did not want that. Now he was not ready to make the changes. It was nothing more than that. Time went by, and the year came to an end. Some people were furious. Where was this so-called book? He had promised. The Macmillan Company had promised. They even had made those buttons and shopping bags, and there were some left over that people were snitching from the warehouse and selling because they had Bob's picture on them, and maybe a picture would be better than the book anyway. There were also a few sets of galleys that had gone around to different people who were being given a preview of the book. These advance review galleys are made of every book. Sometimes they're loose, and sometimes they're bound up with a spiral binding. More time went by. There were still many people who talked about the book and wondered when it would come out. But it couldn't come out unless or until Bob wanted it to. He didn't. The more time that went by, the more curious and furious some people became. "Doesn't matter that it's his work," they said. "Doesn't matter what he wants," they said. "What right has he got anyway?" And so they managed to get hold of a copy or two of those galleys, and they started to make some copies of the copies. They sold even better than the buttons had. Some newspapers saw that this was happening and decided to print parts of the book and long reviews and speculations and denunciations. Bob didn't like this idea, and neither did we. We know that an artist has the right to make his own decisions about what happens to his work, and a publisher should protect this right, not abrogate it. Everyone should know this. You don't take what doesn't belong to you, and the only thing that truly belongs to us is our work. Poets and writers tell us how we feel by telling us how they feel. They find ways to express the inexpressible. Sometimes they tell the truth, and sometimes they lie to us to keep our hearts from breaking. Bob has always been out ahead, working in ways which can be hard to understand. A lot of what he wrote then in Tarantula doesn't seem so hard to understand now. People change, and their feelings change, but Tarantula hasn't been changed. Bob wants it published, and so it is now time to publish it. This is Bob Dylan's first book. It is the way he wrote it when he was 23, just this way. And now you know. The publisher.
Guns, The Falcon's Mouth Book, and Gash Cat Unpunished. Aretha, Crystal Jukebox Queen of Him, and Him diffused in drunk transfusion wound would heed sweet sound wave crippled and cry salute to old great particular El Dorado reel. And ye battered personal guide, but she cannot. She the leader of whom when ye follow, she cannot. She has no back, she cannot. Beneath black flowery railroad fans and fig leaf shades and dogs of all night joes grow like arches and cures the harmonica battalions of bitter cowards' bones and bygones, while what steadier, louder, the moans and arms of funeral landlord with one passionate kiss rehearse from dusk. And climbing into the bushes with some favorite enemy, ripping the postage stamps and crazy mailmen and waving all rank and familiar ambition, and that itself is needed to know that mother is not a lady. Aretha, with no goals, eternally single, and one step soft of heaven. Let it be understood that she owns this melody, along with her emotional diplomats and her earth and her musical secrets. I sense her in a 12-wheel drive semi, stopping in for donuts and pinching the waitress. He likes his women raw and with syrup. He has his mind set on becoming a famous soldier. Manuscript nightmare of cutthroat high and low, and behold the prophesying blind allegiance to Law Fox, Monthly Cupid, and the intoxicating ghosts of dogma. And they, and may the boatmen in bathrobes be banished forever and anointed into the shelves of a live hell, the unimaginative sleep, repetition without change. And fat sheriffs who watch for doom in the mattress. Hallelujah, and boss man of the hobos cometh, and ordaining the spiritual gypsy Davy Camp now being infiltrated by foreign dictator, the pink FBI, and the interrogating unknown failures of peacetime as holy and silver and blessed with the texture of kaleidoscope and the sandal girl. To dream of dancing pillhead virgins and wandering Apollo at the pipe organ, unscientific ramblers and the pretty things lucky and lifting their lips and handing down looks and regards from the shoulders of Adam and Eve's minstrel peekaboo. And passing on a chance to bludgeon the tough spirits and the deed holders into fish-like buffoons and yanking ye erratic purpose. Surrendering to persuasion, the crime against people that be ranked alongside murder. And while doctors, teachers, bankers, and sewer cleaners fight for their rights, they must now be horribly generous. And into the march now, where Tab Hunter leads with his Thunderbird, Pearl Bailey stomps him against a Buick, and where poverty, a perfection of Neptune's unused clients, plays hide-and-seek and escaping into the who goes there. And now's not the time to act silly. So wear your big boots and jump on the garbage clowns, the hourly rate, and the enema men, and where junior senators and goblins rip off tops of question marks, and their wives make pies, and go now and throw some pies in the face, and ride the blinds, and into Aretha's religious thighs. And movement, find ye your nymph of no conscience, and bombing out your young sensitive dignity just to see once and for all if there are holes and music in the universe, and watch her tame the seahorse. Aretha, pegged by choir boys and other pearls of mamas, as too gloomy a much of witchy, and don't you know no happy songs. Lawyer leading a pig on a leash, stopping in for tea and eating a census donut by mistake. He likes to lie about his age and takes his paranoia seriously. The hospitable grave being advertised and given away in whims and in journals the housewife sits on, finding herself financed, ruptured, but never censored in, and also never flushing herself. She denies her corpse the courage to crawl, close his own door, the ability to die of bank robbery, and now catches the heels of old stars making scary movies on her dirt and her face, and not everybody can dig her now. She is private property. Bazookas in a nest, and weapons of ice, and of weatherproof flint, and they twitter, make scars, and kill babies among lady shame, good looks, and her constant foe. Tom Sawyer of the breakfast cereal, causing all females paying no attention to this toilet massacre to be hereafter called Lonzo, and must walk the streets of life forever with lazy people having nothing to do but fight over women. Everybody knows by now that wars are caused by money and greed and charity organizations. The housewife is not here. She is running for Congress. The senator dressed like an Austrian sheep, stopping in for coffee and insulting the lawyer. He's on a prune diet and secretly wishes he was Bing Crosby, but would settle for being a close relative of Edgar Bergen. Passing sugar to Iron Man of the bottles who arrives with a grin and a heat lamp, and he's pushing whodunit buttons this year, and he is a love monger at first sight. You have seen him sprout up from a dumb hillbilly into a bunch of backslap, and he's wise, and he speaks to everyone as if they just answered the door. He don't like people to say he comes from the monkeys, but nevertheless, he is dull and he is destroyingly boring. While Hala the cook scrapes hunger from his floor and pounding it into the floating dishes with roaring, and the rest of the meatheads praising each other's power and argue over acne and recite calendars and point to each other's garments and liquid and disperse into segments and die crazy deaths and bellowing farce mortal farm vomit and why for Jesus Christ be just another meathead. When all the Tontos and Hey Boy lose their legs trying to frug while Kemosabe and Mr. Paladin spend their off hours remaining separate but equal, and anyway, why not wait for laughter to straighten the works out? Meantime, in Huawei smash and the rage of it all, when former lover Cowboy hanging upside down and Susie Q, the angel, putting new dime into this adoption machine as outskirts a symbol squawking and freezing and crashing into the bowels of some hideous soapbox, and it's a rumble. An Iron Man picking up his whodunit buttons and giving them away free and trying to make friends. And even though you belong to no political party, you're now prepared to remember something about something. The chief of police holding a bazooka with his name engraved on it, coming in drunk and putting a barrel in the face of a lawyer's pig. Once a wife beater, he became a professional boxer and received a club foot. He would literally like to become an executioner. What he doesn't know is that the lawyer's pig has made friends with the senator. Gambler's passion and his slave, the sparrow, and he's ranting from a box of black platform and mesmerizing this ball of daredevils to stay in the morning and don't bust from the factories, everyone expecting to be born with whom they love, and they're not, and they've been let down, They've been lied to. And now the organizers must bring the oxen in. And dragging leaflets and gangrene enthusiasm, rat finks and suicide tanks from the payphones to the housing developments, and it usually starts to rain for a while. Little boys cannot go out.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.